the main reason for me to have come up with the book was to show my fans, friends, and maybe budding cricketers what we go through to achieve what we want to achieve in life.
While he was narrating the story, the most memorable thing for me was that I had to sort of get into character to write the book.
I'm very big on values. I have got a chapter where I speak about the values that I feel that people should follow, and also living in this country, about sparing a thought to the less privileged. Retired Hurt to the Best View of the Game. My first book, when we were contemplating on a name, my father, my late father, who was my hero, mentor, came up with the title Retired Hurt. We just thought that was appropriate, considering what I had to go through at the time, and we were also looking at a cricketing term. So that was Retired Hurt. When I decided to do the updated version, I just thought it has to be something connected to the game again, and also what I did after finished playing in 1999. So that's why we have come up with the Best View of the Game subsequently. When I retired from the game that I love so passionately in 1999, a friend of mine, I have to mention his name, David Cruz, got in touch with me and he told me, "Roshan, we know what you have done for the game. I know you have not got the due recognition. I want you to think about coming to Australia, spending some time there, take your mind off what has been going on at the time." And for me, when I reflect now, that was the best thing that happened. I was there with my family for about 4 months. During that period, David said, "You need to do something worthwhile." He got me to do some coaching courses. And also, he introduced me to Ken Pease, who wrote the initial book. For me, I spent a lot of time with Ken, giving my story, and then he was able to put that together. So it was basically conceived by David. He was able to convince me to do the book. We completed it in the year 2000, and I think we released it in 2000 or 2001. And the main reason for me to have come up with the book was to show my fans, friends, and maybe budding cricketers what we go through to achieve what we want to achieve in life. So I hope people can read it in that context, reflect, and see what people go through to achieve their goals. I met Ashan by accident. Sometimes you get a liking to a person. No sooner you meet a person. We met through a talk show that was organized by his organization, which is John Keel's Cinnamon Grand. And they had decided to get Ashan as the moderator. We went through the session. At the end of the session, they had organized a small get together or for us to socialize. And then the topic of my book came up. And Ashan said, "If you ever do decide to do the book or write the book again, I'll be more than happy to do it for you." And I just thought, looking at Ashan's background, he's someone who's played the game at the highest level. He's played for Sri Lanka under 19, represented the country at youth level, excelled in the sport, and also he's gone up the ladder in the corporate world. Because for me, I have been on both sides of the fence in the game of cricket, as a player and also as an administrator. So I just thought he'll understand what I'm trying to relate to him in terms of putting that together. So that's how we met, and that's how I decided to give the opportunity to Ashan to put this together for me.
Adding into that, I think firstly I need to thank Mr. Mahanama for placing his trust in me, because I am not an accomplished or published author per se. Like he said, we met by chance at an event, and I was very fortunate to be in that event to meet him and moderate that session, because for me, when I was growing up, the 96 World Cup team and Mr. Mahanama included were all idols, and I related to him as a right-handed top-order batsman because my batting style was not comparable to his, but somewhat similar. I wasn't the dasher. I was more of the accumulator, which he was, I think, during his playing time as well. So for me, I took that opportunity to prepare myself, read everything about him before the event. And I think that knowledge helped me connect with him after the event. And I was initially just keen on getting my hands on his first book to read it, because I collect autobiographies and I have a small collection of my own. But he explained to me that the book is not available for purchase. So at that point, when he mentioned that he's looking at redoing the book, adding the last 2 decades of his experience as well, I never thought I'll get to shadow author the book. But I said, you know, I do some leisure writing. I write cricket articles. I've written quite a few pieces for magazines and school related stuff. If I can ever help in some capacity, I just thought maybe to edit something or add a few paragraphs or, you know, help him write some content, that he will, you know, take me up on the offer. But I was indeed surprised, and he took a risk with me, and I must thank him once again for taking that risk with me to do the second book, and I hope I have done justice to his story. The most memorable moment, of course, was getting to know Mr. Mahanama more than an idol on TV. You know, you meet someone once and you have an event with them, but then to put this book together, we had to spend so many hours together at home, at coffee shops, you name it. So while he was narrating the story, the most memorable thing for me was that I had to sort of get into character to write the book. Because when you write your own experience, or when you write something that you have viewed, it's your perspective that you're bringing out. But here I have to, like a sort of an actor getting into the role of the movie, I have to sort of imagine certain instances, certain games, certain match situations, certain joyful moments, certain moments of pain, like he would have felt. And that is not very easy, because I didn't really experience it. So to visualize that, imagine that, and then to bring out those emotions writing the book like he would have written the book, made me feel like I was living some of those experiences myself. That was indeed memorable.
Before I answer the question, I need to thank a few people. I will not be able to mention all the names, because I'm bound to miss one or two who helped me throughout in putting this version of the book together. But it's important to thank Darshana Ralapanava, who is the publisher. He's also a young, vibrant personality. Again, I just thought I had to give up-and-coming publisher the opportunity of publishing the book. He also took a lot of trouble in designing, advising us as to how it should come out. So I just thought it was appropriate for me to thank him for all the time and effort. And also, we have got the book translated into Sinhala. I always wanted to have a Sinhala version of the book. Even my previous book, we had a Sinhala version. So I must thank Asoka Gunatilaka for translating on behalf of us, and it should be available in most other bookstores in the country. I hope, like I said, people who will eventually buy the book enjoy reading it. It's just a life story of an individual who has gone through certain challenges to face certain challenges to achieve the desired goals. And also, I'm very big on values. I have got a chapter where I speak about the values that I feel that people should follow, and also living in this country, about sparing a thought to the less privileged. So we have covered that aspect as well in the book, and like I mentioned before, I hope people will enjoy reading it.
Just adding into what Mr. Mahanama said, I would encourage everyone who is a cricket fan or who has followed Roshan Mahanama over the years to purchase the book, not only because you will get inspired by reading the book, but because this book is not a commercial exercise. It is something that Mr. Mahanama is channeling towards charity in terms of the revenue generated after the printing and publishing costs are covered, all the proceedings will go to charitable causes that he is involved with. As most of the readers would know, he is involved with quite a few diverse causes, and I think in this time of need, that is something that is very admirable, because a lot of people write books so that, you know, not only their story goes out, but they make money off it. But this is not a commercial exercise. And even myself as an author, we are not charging any professional fees. I'm doing this purely on, you know, passion for the game and my affiliation with Mr. Mahanama. So I would encourage all the readers to buy the book and help all the causes that Mr. Mahanama is involved with.